Is that really a reason? If he is one, why he say we, royal? Allah is trying to speak like the kings, but any king can say that we. Listen. When Muhammad he says, any Muslim woman, she want to give out her panty to the Prophet. Is that an order from Allah, or this is an order from a horny man? His name is Muhammad.
The Prophet never said that.
Never said that? Well, the verse in the Quran says, and any Muslim woman, she want to give herself to the Prophet so he can if her.
What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with that?
Like, he can
This is coming from God? Any woman, she want to if the Prophet? I mean, the man, he have many wives already. Why he need God to make for him such a verse? What do you mean? Why God, the Muhammad, he have many wives. What does this have to do with Islam now? Muhammad is a prophet of God. He came to tell us about God. Muhammad, he want to spread Islam. Muhammad want to convert us to Islam. But Muhammad now, he want the vagina of our women. What does this have to do with Islam? Why any believing woman, she have a chance, and Muhammad giving her a great opportunity. It's Allah is asking the believers, Allah asking the Muslim women. Any believing woman, she want to give herself to the Prophet so he can, yes, thank you, how it means, so he can if her. I mean, what this have to do with God? Who is the one getting the benefit of this ifing business? The monkey business? Muhammad. The one who created the universe, the one who created the whole world, is making a verse, says, hey female, any one of you would like to have a bang bang, bing bong with the Prophet? Give yourself to the Prophet. Come on. Show me. Silence me. Teach me. I mean, come on.
Well, maybe the Quran, it's not all of it. It's God's word. Like, maybe like the Prophet, he put some like words in it. I don't know.
What do you mean? What does this have to do with God? You see, I am a Christian prince. Let us say I am claiming that I am a prophet. And then I come here in this chat, I have like 1,000 people listening, and I say to them, hey, females in the, you know, who want to sleep with me? Come on, this is crazy, this is sick. This can't be from God. Muhammad already had many wives, he had many slave girls sleeping with them. Why he need a verse from God to say any woman she want to give herself to the Prophet? Obviously, Muhammad now taking advantage of the people, he became a prophet, he became powerful, and he want to have sex with everybody. He don't even respect his followers. Otherwise, you tell me, what is the benefit of this? What does this have to do with God? Why God, he was putting his nose in the panty of Muhammad and the panties of the believers. This is about panties, about our sex. And Muhammad is not a single guy, so Allah, he's trying to find him a good wife. He had many wives already, so what this is about? It's very obvious that Muhammad is fabricating a verse, trying to get women into his bed, claiming that God told him, he's not the guy who cares for that, man, I'm busy. And look what happened. When ugly women, they start coming to Muhammad, what Muhammad he did? Muhammad, he said to himself, I'm getting many ugly women now after I made this verse. So what I will do? I am going to make another verse, says, I have the right to choose the one I like, and I will refuse the one I don't like. I mean, have you ever heard of madness like this? Look what he said. You, O Muhammad, S-A-W, can postpone the women who you will. Postpone? What does that mean? Women, they start coming to Muhammad, they are ugly, and he don't like how they look like. So Muhammad, he starts saying, I said whoever a Muslim woman, she can give herself to me, and now I have a lot of them, and many of them, they are ugly. So how I can get rid of them? So he created another verse, saying, Allah, he told me, I can postpone upon any one of you, and I choose the one I like. I mean, isn't this obvious? So Christian prince, he says, who is a Muslim female? Muhammad, the Christian prince. Who is the female, a Muslima, Muhammad, Fatima, Khadija, Aisha, want to sleep with me? And then all the women, they came to my door. And I look from the window, and I see very scary women outside waiting for me to have sex with them. So now I have to save myself from this. So I create a verse that says, Allah told me I can choose and I pick as I like. Okay? Thank you for coming. You, the woman who there, you are very old and you are overqualified for the business. You are overweight. So thank you very much. I don't like really your face, so you are overqualified too. I mean, what kind of a prophet this prophet is?
Wait, so this verse is saying that he can postpone the turn of whom you will? What does that mean?
The woman who is coming to have sex with him. You see, the Muslim in the translation, they lie. They say wives. None of them became a wife. Not even one of them became a wife. Those women, they want to sleep with him because he just told them in the previous verse, any one of them, they want to sleep with you, they are welcome.
You mean marry them, right?
Not what marry them? Okay, name for me one of the women who gave herself to Muhammad became a wife. Go ahead. He did not marry any of them. Never. It's just for sex. Sexy club. The Prophet sexy club.
Can you show me like the whole verse just so much so I can read
it? I'm showing you the whole verse. Okay, here we go. You can read it, my friend. You can open your Quran from your side if you want. And then here it says, and any believing women, you know, we can change the translation if you want. I mean, there's many translation here. If you don't like this translation, we can change it. You know, whatever you wish.
This is verse 51 of which chapter?
Verse number 50 and 51 in chapter 33. Any woman want to give herself to the prophet, give herself to the prophet. Imagine we say to those people here, they are watching, hey, Christian Prince, Muhammad Hijab, he accept donation as cash and women, please. I mean, come on. Women? I mean, we arrive to the point we have no shame to say that any woman she want to give herself to the prophet. Why is that? What does this have to do with God? How I can serve God by saying any woman she can sleep with me? Unless you're Muslim, you believe that when Muhammad have sex, he have orgasm, and Allah, he have orgasm by Muhammad. Otherwise, what joy that will bring to Allah?
I don't know. This is...
Disgusting, isn't it? You have to agree, my friend. Come on. I advise you to leave Islam immediately.
Well, I don't know because, like, well.
Come on. Like, be honest with yourself. You see, you are a gentleman. You are a gentleman. And I'm sure you don't accept such a thing. I don't think your family, I don't think your history, I don't think your mother, your father are bad people. I think you are coming from a good family. So how in the world you accept such a man come to you and says, any woman she can give herself to me? What does this have to do with God? What servant I'm doing to God by sleeping with Muhammad? Be honest with yourself, my friend. You see, I'm not against you. When I talk to Muslims, they think I hate them. I don't hate Muslims. I would never hate them. My Lord, he ordered me to love everybody. So I am here trying to help you, to show you that what you believe in is a scam. This man is not speaking for God. He's speaking for his panty. He's speaking for his private part. What's the point of this? You see, giving charity, I understand why giving charity is very good. Helping others is very good. But, all good things to do for others are very good. But to do it for Muhammad, it's about sex. And you will see here, it says it's a privilege only for Muhammad. This is a privilege only for Muhammad. Why Muhammad, he needs such a privilege? What that privilege will do for him? What that privilege will do to God? Why the rest of the Muslims do not have such a privilege? You need to ask yourself, my friend, when God, he gave a privilege to someone, what this purpose of this privilege? Is that going to make Islam better? Is that going to convince the Christians that Muhammad is a decent man?
Oh.
Actually, I can show you where your book saying that if the prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, her husband, he must divorce her immediately. Do you believe it?
Wait, come again?
Your Islamic book says that if the prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, which means a woman, she was walking down the street, and Muhammad, he saw her. Her husband, he have to divorce her immediately so the prophet can sleep with her.
Can I see that verse?
All right, not verse. This is in your books. Give me a second. Okay, here we go. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. And read with me here what it says. Amazing. You see the page, right? Muhammad, he been given 16 privilege. 16 privilege. The first one, Safiyul Maghnam, which means the best of the booty. So if we attack a house, the big screen TV go to the Prophet. The small TV goes for you. Al-Istibdadu bi-khums al-khums. Fifth of the booty will go to him. This is the second one. The three is Al-Wisal. The fourth is Al-Ziyada fi Arba'a Niswa, which means to have more than four women. Every Muslim can have only four. Al-Khamis, النكاح بلفظ الهبة. Any woman, she can give herself by just saying that. There's no need for witnesses, no need. He can just if her. السادس, النكاح بلا ولي. A woman, she can give herself to the Prophet without permission from her parents. Imagine, a Muslim, he cannot do that. A woman, she can do that to Muhammad only. السابع, النكاح بغير صداق. Muhammad, he do not need to pay dowry for the women. الثامن, نكاحه في إحالة الإحرام. Even when he is doing إحرام, he can have sex, but Muslims cannot. التاسع, سقوط القسم بين الأزواج. He used to take an oath. Number 9, he can take an oath and he can break the oath. Only him. Muslims cannot do that when he take an oath for women. And العاشر, إذا وقع بصره على إمرأة وجب على زوجها طلاقها وحل له نكاحها. The mic is yours. Translate, please.
Where should I translate from?
إذا وقع بصره.
If he sees a woman, her husband has to divorce her, and she is permissible for
him to F her. Okay. What do you think of this? Why, if your prophet saw a woman, her husband must divorce her immediately, so the prophet, he can sleep with her?
This is like
what servant? What that had to do with God, my friend? What did it have to do with God? Imagine I am a person trying to say to you that I am here coming to serve God. I'm a servant of God. God, he sent me to you, and then I say to you, if I see your wife and I like her, you have to divorce her so I can sleep with her. What kind of religion this religion is?
Well, I mean, like, in the Bible, Solomon had 700 wives.
My friend, the Bible is a book of history and the book of God, which means history of people with God. So, in the Bible, it might say Christian prince, he commits sin. It might say Christian prince commit adultery. It might say that Christian prince, he killed people. It might say Christian prince, he have 1,000 women. But it's not God who told him to have and to do. There's a huge difference. Here, this guy, he claimed that this is coming from his God. We have in the Bible many people who commit sin, and they are asking God for forgiveness. As an example, David himself. He commits sin, and he asked God for forgiveness. He did not say that God told me to look at this woman and sleep with her. He did not make an excuse that this is coming from God. What your prophet doing, he wants women to sleep with him, and he claims it is God. This is a privilege from God. This is not his fault.
I think you're right. This is like wrong.
So my friend, thank you very much. You see, you are a decent man. This guy, I told you, I have a feeling about people, you know. This person is coming from a good family. There's no way his owner will accept such a thing. If Muhammad tried to do that to your wife, I'm sure you will kill him because you have an honor. You are not a trashy person who will accept such a thing. You have dignity.
Yeah, this is wrong.
So denounce Islam, my friend. Say Islam is obviously Muhammad is a false prophet. That's it. Get out of this cult. They fool you. They say to him, he's a trustworthy. He is the good guy. He is the perfect man. He is the perfect between the best of mankind. They worship him. They made him in a point that nobody even dared to question his honor. But the second we start reading, and we did not even read much, there is tons of stories. Disgusting. We are just scratching the surface outside, and look what we found.